Welcome to my YouTube channel for the new EdTech classroom. I'm Sam Kary, and I'm a middle school teacher in San Francisco. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up digital portfolios for students using one of my favorite programs, Seesaw. I feel so strongly that every teacher should be using digital portfolios that I became an official Seesaw ambassador to help teachers learn about the incredible ways the program fosters student ownership over their learning. Whether you're looking for an easy-to-use yet dynamic system for students to showcase their work, need an engaging tool to build students' reflection skills, or simply want to keep parents more in the loop about what their students are creating in class, digital portfolios should be a part of any 21st century classroom. First, I'm going to show you how to get your account set up with the right settings and organization, how to sync your account with Google Classroom, and then invite parents. Then I'll show you some of the ways I use Seesaw to create digital portfolios and foster better metacognition in my students. The first thing you're going to do is create an account as a teacher. I have everything linked to my Google account, so I'm going to click sign in with Google, or you can create an account. You'll be prompted to either create a class or import a class from Google Classroom. I would suggest importing your class directly from Google Classroom if you already have that set up, because then it's going to sync that with your Google Classroom and all your students will already be in Seesaw. After you've set up your Google Classroom, you'll see all the students that are enrolled in your Google Classroom on the right-hand side of your screen. If you want to get students enrolled in your Seesaw account, click the plus students button. There you'll see a class code that you can share with your students. You only need to share that class code with them once. After that, if they're using a Google Gmail account, they can sign right in with their Gmail account. The next thing I'm going to show you is just some quick ways to optimize the settings of your account to maximize the benefits of Seesaw. You'll click that wrench up at the top right-hand side of the screen. There, you'll see a place where you can continue to add students. You can also add families by clicking the plus families button. I'm going to go over that in just a moment. If you want to add different teachers to your account, you can click Manage Teachers. From there, all you have to do is enter a teacher's email address, invite that teacher, and they will be able to create assignments, create their own folders, and have students upload into their portfolio as well. That's really convenient if you teach students that have multiple teachers and want them all to just go to one Seesaw account. Next, you'll see certain functions like student likes and comments, which you can choose to leave on or off. There's also a button that allows students to see each other's work. I turn this button off initially because I just want students to create a portfolio. If we're going to do an assignment where I actually want students to share their work with others, let's say they're showing their thinking about a particular assignment, then I might turn that back on. I do leave that new items require approval on. That way I have to make sure that it meets a particular standard before they can actually submit it into their portfolio. I like to leave on enable item editing so students can go back and edit their work if necessary. When you enable family access, that's going to allow you to invite families to view their students' portfolio, which is a really powerful element of this program that I highly recommend you use. Now, I'm not going to go over all the different ways that you can invite families. You can check that out, but I do want to show you how all you have to do is hit the plus families button, and that will take you to a portal where all you have to do is enter their email or phone number, and that will send the parent a notification for how they can sign in and either access Seesaw from a mobile device or from their computer. Then they'll have access to their student's portfolio and they can see the work that students are creating all year round. It's really great. The last thing I want to show you about settings is how you can manage your folders. Managing folders is important if you have students in different classes or if you just want to subdivide and organize their accounts. I recommend that you set this up prior to getting kids in so that you have a clear organization system. If you go to manage folders, you'll see that I've already created a folder called student-led conferences. I might want to create another folder like reading comprehension to have students add work to. And there you see I have two different folders. When you're setting up folders, it's important that you go to the show add to folder step. Rather than just teachers, you want that to be students and teachers. This way, when a student adds a new piece of work to their portfolio, they will be required to put it in a particular folder first. Okay, now you've set up your basic Seesaw platform. Let's look at different ways that students can upload work and start reflecting on it. Here I am now in the student portal. There are three main ways that I like to have students upload work. There are more options, but these are the three that I use the most frequently. The first is by having students upload an assignment directly from Google Classroom. The next is that they're going to take a screenshot of their work using a Chrome extension that you're going to install to your browser. And the third is that they would take a photo of their work and upload it to the program. So let's start first with looking at how they could upload an assignment from Google Classroom. Anytime a student adds an assignment, they're going to click that green plus button. Here, students will want to go to upload if they're trying to get an assignment that's already in Google Classroom. They can go to their Google Drive. There they will see all the different assignments that they've already created for you in your Google Classroom. In this case, my demo student doesn't have a lot of work, but if the student did have a lot of work and it was hard to find in the assignments below, you could click on the folder for Google Classroom, and there the student would find all of the assignments that they had uploaded through your Google Classroom. So let's say that the student wants to upload a slide presentation. They would click select, and there they will see their assignment directly from Google Classroom. They can either add a voice recording to explain that piece of work or a caption. I'm going to show you those tools in a moment. Once a student is ready to submit their work, they hit the green check button on the top right-hand side of the screen. They'll select which folder they want that assignment to go into, click the green check button, and there it will be waiting for teacher approval. So on your teacher account, you're going to see that a student submitted work. You'll have to approve that before it comes in. We'll look at what that looks like in just a moment. The next thing that I want to show you is how you can have a student upload a piece of work using the photo function. So here, they would again click add. They would click photo. Students can hold up an assignment that they want to include, select the picture icon, and then their picture will show up with a lot of different annotation tools that they can use to talk about their work. When the student is ready to submit their work to the teacher, they click the green check. Again, select what folder it goes into, and it will wait for teacher approval. The next really cool thing that I want to show you is how you can use the Seesaw Chrome extension to actually take a screenshot directly from a program that students are using in class. Direct students to go to the Google Web Store. There, they will select Seesaw. It's the top app, Reflect in Seesaw extension. Click Add to Chrome. And there, students will see that they have the Seesaw extension on the top right-hand corner of their screen. You can then direct them to go to a website where they might have an assignment that they want to capture and put into Seesaw. So for example, right now I'm going to go to storyboard that. Here, a student might want to include a screen capture of their work, and rather than screenshot it, put it in a folder and then upload it, you can use the app to just directly screenshot it and have it go right into Seesaw. The way you're gonna do that is by clicking on the Seesaw extension. Capture selected area or visible area will capture the entire screen. If you capture the selected area, you can choose where you want the screenshot to be. That will open up Seesaw, and you'll see that it's now in the Seesaw portal. So here I want to show you some of the different annotation tools that I direct students to be able to start to reflect on their work. The first is to add a text box. When you click the text box, it'll pop up a box, and I like to first direct students to title their assignment so that we know what we're looking at. You'll see that these are dynamic. You can drag them around. You can change the size, change the color, change the backfill, any way that you want. If a student wants to add a voice recording, they could add a voice recording explaining why they chose the assignment. They could take a picture and use that to explain why they chose the assignment. I like to direct students to using different shapes so that they can point to particular parts of their assignment. So here I'm going to select the arrow shape. I'll drag the arrow next to the dialogue. I'm going to turn that arrow around, drag it, make it smaller. And then I'm going to add another text box to explain why I am pointing to that particular part of the assignment. So I'll click the text box. I'll move that text box over. And here I would direct students to explain what their work shows. One of our learning targets was to have students be able to write dialogue from nonfiction text. So that's what the student wrote. Next, I want to have the student reflect on how they visualize what they had read by creating another annotation. So they'll select another arrow. Here, I'm going to have the text box up in the top corner. So I'm going to actually move that arrow around a little bit, draw it out, add a text box, write the target. There are other tools that students can use to annotate their work. For example, the pens at the bottom with different colors that they can use to write directly on their work and comment on that particular section. The next thing I direct all my students to do is go down to the quotation marks. Here, they either add a voice caption further explaining why they chose that assignment, or they do a written caption. I always provide my students with sentence frames here that include a part about what the work shows in terms of reaching a learning target, as well as why they are proud of their work. Now let's look at what it looks like in my teacher portal now that the student has uploaded some work. I see that I have different assignments to review. I'm going to click the review button. I can review their work. If I approve it and think that it does belong in their portfolio, I can click that green check. If I think, you actually need to go back and fix that, it doesn't work, I can trash can it, delete it, and they will have to upload that assignment again. The next thing that I want to show you is how a student's portfolio would look after you've approved all their different assignments into their portfolio. You'll see that they have a stream of different assignments that they have annotated and reflected upon that can then be shared with families and that they will have for the rest of the year. And if you have a pro account, can go with them over multiple years that they are with a school. The last thing that I want to show you is just how it looks on the teacher end and how easy it is to pull up different students' portfolios. If you want to look at all the work that your class has put together, you can click on the class journal. And if you just want to see work that certain students have uploaded, you can click their names and it will show you their portfolio. I also find this to be incredibly convenient when I'm actually running conferences and I want to pull up different students for my conference. I love how Seesaw allows students to reflect on their work in dynamic ways that is meaningful to them, how it keeps their work all in one place, and how it allows me to share that work with families so that they get to see their students' work all year round instead of just at the end when we have our student-led conferences. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you'd like to see more of my education technology tutorials, hit that red subscribe button. Below, you can also find a link to my website, as well as my Twitter handle and my podcast, where I have conversations with other educators about how they use technology in class and industry professionals about the latest and greatest in education technology. Thanks again and have a great week.